Students of standard 8, now we have to do the last part of lesson number 3. The last part has a few sentences of direct and indirect speech. But before we start doing those sentences, we'll just revise about direct and indirect speech and then finally we'll do those sentences. The first thing, direct and indirect speech. Direct speech means what? Something that is directly said by the person. Say for example, the teacher tells you something in the school, that is direct speech. Now when you go home and tell the same thing to your mother, that the teacher told us so and so thing to them, that becomes indirect speech. Why? And that becomes reported speech. Why? Because you are reporting it to someone else. You are saying the same thing to someone else. So that is indirect speech. Now when we change sentences from direct to indirect, there are certain rules that we have to follow. I've written a few sentences over here to make your work clear. The first sentence, Shiva says, I am eating an apple pie. Okay, first of all, whenever we write sentences of direct speech, we have to put a comma. This is open inverted. Then, at the end of the sentence, according to the sentence, it can be a full stop, it can be a question mark, it can be an exclamation mark, and then close it. Okay, it's never close inverted and then full stop or question mark. Whatever the punctuation, full stop, question mark or exclamation. These three can be there at the end of the sentence and then the close inverted. Now when you change it to indirect, we have to remove this part. Okay, so Shiva says, now instead of this, what did we write? That. Okay, who is I over here? I is Shiva, so we'll write he. Am is present tense. He is eating an apple pie. Okay. Now, after I explain you the second type of sentence, I'll explain you the difference. So, Shiva says, now this comma and open inverted. We don't have to write that in indirect speech. See, we don't have to put that comma, open inverted, close inverted, all that in indirect speech. Okay. So, Shiva says that he is eating an apple pie and a full stop. Now we didn't put the open inverted, we are not going to put the close inverted also. Okay, second, Brijesh will say, I am not well and cannot exert myself. Now we started with Brijesh will say, again this comma and open inverted, instead of that what will we put to join the sentence? See, this is the word that connects. This is one part of the sentence. This is the second part of the sentence. Now with the help of the word that, what are we doing? We are connecting both. So for direct speech, your answer will be Brijesh will say that for the connecting word. I is he. Is, because this is am. See, with I it is always am. So it is I am. But when we change that I to he, with he in the present tense, it is. He is not well and cannot exert. Now see myself. Who is this myself? Brijesh. So we'll write and cannot exert himself. Instead of myself, we'll make it because I he made it he. Myself will become himself. And then a full stop. Okay, now over here. See, this is present tense. And in the indirect speech also we made it present tense. Present, for the indirect we made it present tense only. Why? Because this word is says. Okay, when this word is says, you have to keep it the sentence in present tense only. But not always. See, when you change a direct sentence to indirect, you have to change it to past tense. You have to change the verbs to past tense. But where you will keep it in the present tense only, if the word is says over here, you will keep present tense as present. The second type of sentence is, the girl said, I am scared of monsters. Now see, I am scared of monsters. So how do we change it to indirect? The girl said, now for connecting both these sentences, we use the word that. The girl said that. Now who is I? I is the girl. So for the girl, we will use she. That she. Am is present tense, so am will become was. She was scared of monsters. Okay, Now one question that will come to your mind is, in the earlier sentence, for am we made it is. See over here. For this sentence, for am we made it is. Why? Because over here the word is says. When it is says over here, okay, what do? We keep the present tense as present tense only. But when you come to this sentence, over here the word, the reporting word is said. Said is past tense. So over here, since it is said, we have to change the verbs to past tense. So over here, am becomes was. Okay, if it would have been says over here, we would have written is. But it is said over here, so we write was. Same way, Rohan said the homework is easy. So we'll write Rohan said. For this comma and open inverted, for connecting we'll use the word that. Rohan said that. Okay, one more thing you remember is, see, after open inverted the first letter has to be capital. Whenever, when you grow up, you'll have sentences where you have to do punctuations, put proper punctuations. Always remember, after comma and open inverted, the first letter, whatever the first letter has to be capital. Okay, now this capital, now see over here, when we change it over here, it won't remain a capital letter because this is a continuous sentence. You cannot write T capital over here somewhere in the middle of the sentence, okay? So take care of that also. You remove the comma and open inverted. Instead of that, you have written that. The homework is becomes was. The homework was easy. So present tense becomes past tense. Okay. A few words that we can change. We have to change when we change from direct to indirect. Say suppose it is, it becomes was. Like is becomes was. Or if it is am also, it becomes was. So, is or am becomes, in indirect speech it becomes was. But if it is already was in your this sentence, in your direct sentence, if it is already was, then your answer you have to write had been. Say for example, if it is written was over here, the homework was easy instead of this. So, we would have written had been. Okay? So, remember this. If it is, it changes to was. But in the direct speech sentence, if it is was, we make it had been. But if it is already had been over here. See, present tense to past tense. Past tense becomes past perfect. And in past perfect, there is only one word, had. Okay? Now, if it is already had been over here, there will be no change. In the indirect speech also, you write the same had been. If it is had, it becomes had. If it is have also, it becomes had. See, past perfect has only one word, had. But in the direct speech, if it is already had over here, then there is no change. So if it is had been, you write had been only. If it is had, you write had only. Do is present tense. Do becomes did. But in your direct speech, if they already write did, then there is no change, okay? Did will remain did only over here. Okay, next very easy thing. Will becomes would, shall becomes should, must becomes had to. But if these words are used in direct speech, if already over here it is will, shall, if it is would, okay, or should, or if it is had to, then there will be no change. If these words are used over here again, then there is no change. Will becomes would, shall becomes should, must becomes had to. But if these words are there is no change. You will use the same word. Can becomes could and may becomes might. See, these rules are very easy to remember if you just keep on practicing sentences, okay? So, this will also be very clear when you will practice a few sentences. Okay, a few more words that you need to change when you change sentences from direct to indirect. The first one over here. Here, if the word here is written in direct speech, it becomes there. This becomes that. these becomes those. Tomorrow means the day after. See, whenever in the direct speech sentence you have the word tomorrow, in indirect it changes to the day after or the following day. Next, today means that day. Yesterday means the day that's already gone, right? So yesterday becomes the day before or the previous day. See, over here tomorrow is the day after and yesterday is the day before. Over here it is following day, over here it is previous day. Tonight becomes that night. Today becomes that day. Tonight becomes that night. Ago becomes before. Now becomes then. Last week, previous week. Last month, previous month. So these are a few more words that you have to change when you change a sentence from direct speech to indirect speech. Now see one more thing. If there are sentences which are universal truth. Universal truth means earlier also it was like that. Today it is also like that. Say for example 2 and 2 makes 4. So earlier also 2 and 2 make 4 and today also it makes 4. Okay, there is no change. So such sentences are called universal truth. Means it's always the same. Now see, the teacher said the earth revolves around the sun. Okay, so over here instead of revolve, if you change it to past tense, revolve means pehle hota tha, ab nahi hota, aisa to nahi hai, it still is like that, okay? So such sentences are called universal truth. Now see, when you have to change such a sentence, you write the teacher said, now for this comma and open inverted we write that. The earth revolves. See, revolves is present tense. But for sentences which are universal truth, it remains the same. You don't change it to past tense. You don't try to revolve, okay? You have to keep revolves as revolves only. Revolves around the sun. Okay? Now, same way, another. My mother said, water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Now, see, water always boils. Earlier also, now also, it's the same. So, we write, my mother said that water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Over here, boils, we don't change it to past tense, boiled, okay? Because at present also, it's the same. So, present tense remains present tense when sentences are universal truth. Now, one more type of sentence. Reena said to me, I must complete my work now. Now, see, over here it's only the teacher said. Who is saying is only written. But over here, who is saying to whom also it's written. Do you understand the difference? Over here it is the teacher said. But over here what is there? Reena said to me. So the person who is saying and to whom it is being said, both are mentioned over here. So for such sentences, said you will change it to told. So you have to write Reena said to me. Instead of that you write Reena told me, okay? When both the people are mentioned in the beginning, who is saying and to whom it is being said, if both is mentioned in the beginning, you have to use the word told, okay? So Reena told me. Now instead of this comma and open inverted, we use the word that. Okay, I, who is I? Reena, so we will write she. Must, we just did. Must changes to had to. So I become she. Must changes to had to. Complete my work. My is Reena, so my becomes whose work? Her. So she had to complete her work. Now becomes then. We did it just now only. Now becomes then. So now in the direct speech becomes then in the indirect speech. See, understand. This sentence, it has only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 words. But from 6 words also we needed to change 4 words. Okay. So it is not like that. Okay. Ek word change kar diya to khatam ho gaya sentence. No. There are sentences where you have to change a lot of words to make it into indirect. Like this sentence. See. I became she, must became had to, my becomes her, now becomes them. So out of 6 words, we changed 4 words. Okay. Now see next. Maya said to Radha, the book is very interesting. So who is saying to whom? Both are mentioned before this inverted comma. So you have to use the word told. So Maya told Radha that the book is becomes was. The book was very interesting and a full stop. The next type of sentences are interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences are sentences which ask questions. Okay, for such type of sentences, there are two rules that you have to remember. Now, with the help of examples, you'll understand them. The first is, he said, what is in the bag? Now, see, what is in the bag is a question. So, we put a question mark. Now, see, which word does the question start with? What? Now, understand one thing. For direct indirect speech, if the question starts, you have to look at this word, okay? Say you have to look at which word the question starts with. After inverted comma, which is the first word. Over here it is what, which, when, who, whom, whose, how, what. These are called WH questions. Now see, if the question starts with a WH question, in the answer also you have to use the same word. Same word will be used in the answer. What in the answer we have used what. Which in the answer we have used which. Okay. So same word you will put in the answer. Now say he said what is in the bag. Okay. Over here since it is a question. Instead of said you have to use the word asked. He asked what. What will remain what only. Okay. Is becomes past tense. What. Was. What was in the bag? Okay. Now see what have we done? He asked what was in the bag. This is not a question now. So it will be full stop. Don't put this question mark over here. Okay. What is in the bag is a question. So we put a question mark. But now we have to read the whole thing like this together as one sentence. This is not a question. We have to put a full stop. Next. The teacher said which story was easy. The teacher, whenever there is a question, you have to use the word asked. So the answer will be the teacher asked which remains which only. So when there are WH questions, you have to use the same word again. Which story? Now see over here it is was. Over here it is, we made it was. Now if it is already was, we make it had been. Okay? This is a rule we read it before, just now. So if in the direct speech it is becomes was. But if was is written in the direct speech sentence, then was changes to had been. Okay, the story had been easy. So all these are WH questions. Okay, which, when, who, whom, whose, how, what. When these words come, you have to use the same word again in your answer. Now the next type of interrogative sentences are yes, no questions. Yes, no question means the answer can be yes or no. For such sentences, you have to use the word if or you can use whether. Now, look at this sentence. She said, did you bring the vegetables? Okay. Now, see, again, did you bring the vegetables is a question. So, instead of said, we will use the word asked. She asked. Okay. Now, for this, we earlier what did we use? We used that. But now we are not going to use that. See, did you bring the vegetable? The answer can be yes or the answer can be no. So such questions are called yes, no questions. For yes, no question, for the connecting word, you can use if or you can use whether. Any of the word, okay? She asked if you, say for example, you, we consider you to be a girl. If she did bring, so becomes had brought the vegetables. Bring the past tense becomes brought. She said to him, will you play today? Now see, will you play today? The answer can be yes or no. So she said, instead of said, we'll use the word asked. She asked him, in this sentence I'd use if, over here I'll use whether. You can use if over here, no problem, okay? She asked him whether he, who is this you? This one. So he will becomes would. So if he would play today, I just explained it to you. Today in the indirect speech becomes that day. See, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 words. Out of 4, we had to change 3 words. Will becomes would, you, who So he play today becomes that day. So for interrogative sentences, if it is WH question, use the same word again in the answer. If it is a yes no question, you have to use if or you can use whether. So after understanding these basic rules about direct and indirect sentences, we'll do the exercise that's written in the textbook. In your textbook on page number 32, they have given you a few sentences. That's activity 10 on page number 32. That is what we are going to do now. They have given you a few sentences and you have to change them to indirect. And we just revise the rules for direct and indirect sentences. Now see, Bob, the first sentence is, you are not Jimmy Wales, Bob said. And the answer also they have given in the textbook. Bob snapped. Now see, there are a few words that are given over here. When you write your answers, you have to use those words, okay? So over here it is, Bob snapped that he was not Jimmy Wales. Second, good night, sir, said the policeman. Now see, when you wish, say good night or good morning, bye bye, things like that, you have to use the word did. So the answer will be, the policeman bid good night. It has given me everything I asked for, said Bob. So again, see, just recall the rules. So we'll write, Bob posted. Badai marke bol raha hai ki yahan mujhe sab kuch mila. So Bob posted that. It has will become had. Given me, will me Bob. So we'll write him. Everything I asked for, I becomes, I will I Bob. So we'll write he. Asked. See, asked is already past tense. So if it is already past tense, we have to make it past perfect. So past perfect is had asked for. So your answer will become, Bob posted that it had given him everything he had asked for. Next is, if Jimmy is alive or not, he will be here by that time, he said to the officer. He said to the officer. Who is saying to whom is written in the beginning of the sentence. So you will write the word told. He told the officer that if Jimmy is becomes was. If Jimmy was alive on the earth, he will becomes would be. Here becomes there by that time. Okay, so he told the officer that if Jimmy was alive on the earth, he would be there by that time. Did pretty well out in the west, didn't you? Asked the policeman. What is the policeman asked? Because it is a question. Now see, did pretty well out in the west? The answer can be yes or no. And as I just explained you, if the question is yes, no question, you have to use if or whether. So I use if. The policeman asked if he had done pretty well out in the west. So, didn't you? So, he did. Did becomes had done. Okay. So, the policeman asked if he had done pretty well out in the west. I came 1,000 miles to stand in this door tonight, said the man at the door. So, the man at the door said that. Now see, I came. Who is I, the man? So we use he. Came is already past tense. So if it is already past tense, we have to make it past perfect. So we make it had come. He had come 1,000 miles to stand in. This door becomes that door. That door tonight becomes that night. So the whole sentence will become, the man at the door said that he had come 1,000 miles to stand at that door that night. Now see, direct indirect sentences, there are a few more types of sentences also, like exclamatory sentences, like imperative sentences. Today what we did was assertive sentences and we did interrogative sentences. Okay, there are two more types of sentences in direct indirect speech that we'll do later on, but since this covers your part of lesson number 3, so now with this we are over with lesson number 3. What you will do is, all the sentences that were done today on the board, you will copy all those sentences, plus I had also made a list of what is the word in the present tense, how you in the direct speech, how you change it in the indirect speech, what is it in the present tense, how you make it in the past tense, everything that was written you will copy it in your notebook neatly. And that's the end of lesson number 3. So all the question answers and all the activities that were done, see that you will copy it in your notebooks.